Dear students, with these few slides, I will discuss about what is pheromone and how does it work in insect communication. As regard the term pheromones, it derives from two Greek words. Firstly, phero means to transport and hormone means to stimulate. It is regarded as an ectohormone which is secreted by some animals, especially you will found in case of insect, and they mediate the communication between them. This slide shows a general characterization of pheromones, and you just read and tell me if you feel any doubt. And this slide shows mechanism of pheromone action. With this flowchart, you can easily understand their mechanism. I am not going through the details of these slides. Just you learn and then tell me and try to clear the doubts. This slide shows classification of pheromone based on three different aspects. First one is changes in insect, which include two types, primer pheromone and releaser pheromone. Second one based on functional group includes type 1 and type 2. And third one based on number of compounds includes monocomponent and multicomponent. I will discuss in detail in later slides. As regards primer pheromone, it may be stated that they trigger off a chain of physiological changes in the recipient without any immediate changes in the behavior. Primer pheromones have longer term physiological effects on the receiver. Examples of primer pheromones include termite cause differentiation, locust development rates. Any pheromone that has effects on the development of the organism receiving the signal is considered a primer pheromone. Several primer pheromones affect juvenile hormone levels and other endocrine glands of recipients. Pheromones inhibit differentiation of pseudogates. It is a good example of termite cursed determination. In case of locust, adults and nymphs have separate aggregation pheromone systems. Aggregation pheromone produced by gregarious is mediated by primer pheromone, so it acts as a primer that speeds up maturation of females. Nymphal aggregation pheromones have the primer effect of slowing down the development of adults of either sex and lead to synchronized development of locust. There are more about releaser pheromones. Produce an immediate change in the behavior of the recipient. The behavior includes, on the basis of behavior, they may be classified as follows: sex pheromones, aggregation pheromones, anti-aggregation pheromone, alarm pheromones, egg-laying pheromones, etc. Releaser pheromones elicit an immediate behavioral response in the recipient. Most pheromones are releaser pheromones and are divided into groups based upon their function, such as sexual behavior, aggregation, alarm, recruitment, and territorial. Now coming to the type 1 pheromone. These pheromones contain carbon 12 to carbon 18 in their chains and functional groups includes alcohol, aldehyde and acetate. They are biosynthesized from de novo synthesis fatty acid, used in approximately 75% of the moths. Example, Lepidopteran moths. Type 2 pheromones contains unsaturated hydrocarbons and their epoxy derivatives. They have carbon number 17 to 23 and originate from long chain hydrocarbons produced outside the pages, synthesized in oocytes and epidermal cells. Example include cockroach and members of Geometritidae and Arctitidae. Now coming to monocomponent. This pheromone contains only one chemical compound, as we found in case of silkworm, that is bombycol. Multicomponent pheromones have more than one component. Examples are found in case of bark beetle, pink bollworm and cockroach. Another multicomponent, tobacco cutworm, can produce this type of pheromone. Gram pod borer and honeybee queen, you know, the queen substance. Now coming to different pheromone secretory organs in insect. Exocrine glands are divided into two types based on their structural organization of secretory cells. Type 1. Glands with secretory cells of type 1 are directly derived from the tegumental epidermis. Secretory cells form a monolayered epithelium either as part of the external body tegument through which they directly discharge their secretory products. Type 2. It is more complex. The gland is formed by variable number of bicellular units, each comprising a secretory cells and duct cell. Now coming to behavioral response to pheromone. There are several behaviors which are mediated by pheromone, and this slide shows such phenomena. Aggregation and host marking pheromones lead to the formation of groups near the pheromone source. This may be through attracting organism or stopping passing conspecifics. Parasitic insects often mark their host using host marking pheromones. Host marking species lay their eggs in host of limited size, which can successfully support developing parasitoid larvae. Alarm pheromones are fight or flight responses to stressful environments. Bees release an alarm pheromone soon after stinging a predator. Slave-making ants take advantage of alarm pheromone as well. Among social insects, trail following or recruitment pheromones are clearly defined. These pheromones are useful in foraging and recruitment to food. Pheromones in the form of scent marks have an important role in territorial behavior in insects. A benefit of scent mark comes from the unique separation of signaler and signal. Territorial pheromones have a low energy investment. Pheromones produced by social insect queens perform both primer and releaser functions in controlling colony behavior. Primer pheromones function by physiologically altering the reproductive system. The queen also emits a releaser pheromone to attract workers to their queen. Worker produced pheromones. Workers do not produce queen pheromone. Their main mandibular gland is used in royal jelly. Other worker produced pheromones are often used in alarm and defensive behavior. Some predators conceal their own odor in order to gain acceptance into social insect colonies. This is achieved through the use of cuticular hydrocarbons. Many mutualistic interactions between conspecifics require chemical cues. Interspecific interaction between insects and other species in which both benefit is mutualistic. An excellent example may be the interaction between ants and Lycaenid butterfly caterpillars. Pheromonal excretions of insects may be exploited by conspecific predators or parasites through eavesdropping. Pheromone communication in social insects also includes recognition of kin. Recognition of members of the same family in insects may be mediated by chemical cues such as pheromones. Nestment recognition is another common facet of pheromone communication. Recognition of members of the same nest site is vastly important in protecting of the nest site. Synthesis of insect pheromones may be exploited industrially by means of synthesizing pheromones of insect pests. These pheromones may be proven useful in protecting crops and residents. Pest management may be mediated through mass trapping, lure and kill matting disruption. Now coming to the factors affecting the pheromone production. Number 1, temperature. Number 2, photo period. 3, host plant. And 4th, age and mating. Thank you, students. This is all about today. We will come in next session. Thank you very much for your patience hearing.